impulse behind it was that we are coming into more and more polarized times. So this was before Trump, this was before his candidacy. But I was feeling like yes. we were coming into times that were going to cause us to separate. Yes. And I had a friend who said something like, I will die on the hill of. It's like the thing that you're not going to let go of. And I was like, so this is for people who are willing to die on the hill of oneness, who aren't going to sacrifice, who aren't going to relinquish oneness, you know? Mm-hmm. And what's so hard about that is holding on to that in the face of the increasing polarization, with the increasing sense of harm and isolation. So I was just having a conversation with a woman of color who's involved with, diversity work at her school, right? A leader. Quote, I feel so isolated. Amanda, end quote. I was talking to someone who's European American, and she said, I feel so isolated. You know what I mean? Change makers, both of these people change in different spaces. And it struck me that when I heard her say that, when the woman of color said it, I could totally get it because I was like, I've been in your shoes, you know, shifting an institution, one of very few, blah, 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 blah. When she said it, it wasn't that I hadn't heard it before, but I heard it so close to the woman of color saying it that I recognized, wow, the way the system works is it does have us feel isolated. It has us feel so separate from each other, you know? So to hold on to the hill of oneness in the midst of cultivating justice and compassion, it's like to stand with your feet in both spaces, justice and compassion, it is hard. It is uncommon, you know? It requires wisdom and a big heart and like a spiritual grounding and, you know, all that stuff from your ancestors. It just cannot be done with the ego or the mind because it doesn't make sense to hold on to it from that perspective. So you gotta call on everybody to help you hold on to that. Meaning, you know, your European American ancestors, you gotta call on your men, male identified. You need it all to hold on to that. I'm realizing this, speaking this to you. So without having access to all of them, this tribe, will feel isolated. We will feel isolated. You know, Ruby Sales says, you can't coerce me into hating you. Mm-hmm. It's like, mm-hmm. I mean, when people take that self-determination, you know, I got me. That's powerful. And it needs to be nurtured.